Dear students, this is our second video of marketing chapter. Today we are going to discuss recent trends in marketing. There is a major shift in the techniques in recent past, so the trends in marketing are e-business, telemarketing, m-business, green marketing, retail marketing, customer relationship management, and relationship marketing. So, first one, e-business. E-business means electronic business, commonly referred to as e-business, may be defined as the administration of conducting business through internet. The use of internet and web technology in business is commonly known as e-business. E-business derived from such a term as email and e-commerce is the conduct of business on the internet, not only buying and selling but also servicing customers and collaborating with business partners. Electronic business or e-business may be defined broadly as any business process that relies on an automated information system, mostly done with web-based technology. Next one, different modes of e-business. First one, business to business, B2B. Business to consumer, B2C. Consumer to consumer, C2C. Business to government, B2G. Fifth one, consumer to business, C2B. Last one, peer to peer model. These are the important modes of e-business. So let us discuss in detail. First one, business to business, that is B2B. Business to business is one of the major forms of e-commerce and represent business transactions between business, such as between a producer, distributors and a wholesaler, or between a wholesaler and a retailer. For example, professionals track and trace for dealer, etc. This is B2B. Next one, B2C. B2C means business to consumer. In this model, transactions take place between consumers and business houses. Here, individuals are also involved in the online business transactions. Next one, consumer to consumer, that is C2C. In this model, business transaction is carried between two individuals using a platform in the form of intermediary. It helps the online dealing of goods or services among consumers. Next one, B2G. B2G means business to government. Business to government is a business model that refers to business selling products, services or information to governments or government agencies. An example of a business to government company is a firm that offers IT consulting services to a government agencies. Next one, consumer to business, that is C2B. It is a business model where the end consumer creates products and services which are consumed by business and organization. Next one, last one, peer to peer model. It is another model of e-business in which people instantly share related computer files and computer sources without having to interact with the central web server. These are the important modes of e-business, modes or types of e-business. Next one, need, importance and advantages of e-business. First one, helps in presentation of products and services effectively. E-business helps in presentation of products and services effectively. Next one, provide adequate information about products and services. Third one, no need for start and manage business. Next one, eliminate market intermediaries. And last one, reduce time and money spent. next one, disadvantages of e-business. First one, lack of personal touch. Next one, lack of clear defined cyber laws. Third one, returning goods, replacement and exchange is problem. Last one, not suitable for all products. These are the important disadvantages of e-business. Now we have to study telemarketing. Telemarketing means it is a method of direct marketing in which salesperson solicits prospective customer to buy products or services either over a phone or through a subsequent face-to-face. Simply, telemarketing basically means selling over telephone. Telemarketing basically means selling over telephone. It is a process of contacting people on a qualified list to sell services over the phone. Telemarketing is a form of direct marketing where the prospective customer are identified and qualified by various means including past purchase histories, previous requests for information, credit limit, competition entry forms or applications. So telemarketing basically means selling over telephone. So it is a method of direct marketing. First one, advantages of telemarketing. First one, it is less expensive compared to most other form of selling. It is less expensive. Next one, provide a more interactive and personal sales services. It provide more interactive and personal sales services. Third one, generate and leads to other appointment. Next one, sell to both existing and new customer. Fifth one, explain technical issues more clearly. Sixth one, achieve results that are measurable. Seventh one, operation 24/7. That is SMS and MMS. Telemarketing means telemarketing is a method of direct marketing. Next one, disadvantages of telemarketing. First one, customer list can be very costly. Customer list can be very costly. Next one, training staff can be time consuming and costly. For providing training for staff, it is very time consuming and costly. Next one, customer list may not always be clean and accurate. These are the important disadvantages of telemarketing.
ആകു അച്ചാക്കല്ല, ഞാൻ റെപ്പോസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടേ പറഞ്ഞു. ആകു പുറത്ത് പോകുന്നുണ്ട്, പോ അച്ഛൻ്റെ അടുത്ത്. ഞാൻ ഇത് റെക്കോർഡ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് ഒന്ന് കയ്യട്ടെ.
നെക്സ്റ്റ് വി ഹാവ് ടു സ്റ്റഡി ദ മെത്തേഡ്സ് ഓഫ് ടെലിമാർക്കറ്റിംഗ്. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ, ഇന്ററാക്റ്റീവ് വോയിസ് റെസ്പോൺസ്. സെക്കൻഡ് വൺ, വോയിസ് ചാറ്റ്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ, ടെലി ഷോപ്പിംഗ്. Fourth one, voice and text message. Fifth one, broadcast fax. First one is interactive voice response. Interactive voice response or IVRS has many applications in marketing. It can be used to answer frequently asked questions about products or services through pre-recorded message through IVRS round the clock. The IVRS enables automatic reading of basic information about products or a services for the caller. The IVRS can also be programmed to allow the callers record their message or queries about products and services. Next one, voice chat. Voice chat programs and video chat networks were mainly used for personal entertainment like popular dating and to make international phone calls. For a long time, voice chat platforms were beset by poor technical quality, relatively high pricing for services. Next one, teleshopping. Teleshopping involves marketing of goods and services by customers using a telephone or using computer aided device or television or combination of these. Next one, voice chat and text message. Voice or text message refers to message sent or received using media such as cellular device or using internet. The main benefit of marketing products and services using a voice or text mail or message is that it can generate thousands of ready to buy respondents with customers subject to customer interest in the product. This is voice and text message. Last one, broadcast fax. Broadcast faxing involves use telephones and fax machines to send multiple recipients. However, it is not popular these days. In the past, this method was widely used in developed countries, mostly for business-to-business marketing campaigns. These are the important methods of telemarketing. Next, we have to study the term M-Business. This is one of the important trends in marketing. M-Business is a process of buying and selling of goods and services through wireless technology like mobile phones, wireless application protocols. That means M-Business is a branch of electronic commerce which include buying and selling of goods and services through wireless handled devices such as cellular phones, personal digital assistants, that is PDAs. The important advantages of M-Business. First one, it improved customer services. Next one, increased productivity and flexibility. Next one, interactivity. Fourth one, global reach. Fifth one, better data. Sixth one, reducing time to order. These are the important advantages of M-Business. Next, we have to study what are the important features of M-Business. First one, any time and anywhere transaction capability. Next one, service through wireless handled services. Third one, wider reach. Last one, provide adequate security. Next we have to study what are the important disadvantages of M-Business. First one, SMS limited to small number of character and text. Next one, use of graphics limited. Third point, limited hand width. Fourth point, security of data moved across some mobile and wireless network. These are the important disadvantages of M-Business.